Welcome to our chemistry practical session. From this slide, do you have any idea what will be our today's topic? Yeah, it's about water. It's related with water. Now, we get water from different sources. When water coming through the earth, it's contaminated with the soil sediments and also with the pollution from air pollution, industrial pollution, and many metals like iron, magnesium and calcium are mixed with the water. This is the cause of the hardness of the water. So now you can guess what is the cause of the hardness of the water. Mainly the two metals, calcium and magnesium, bivalent two metals, calcium and magnesium are the main reason for the hardness of the water. And these two metals are present in water as their bicarbonate and sulfate salts. So you can understand these four are the main salts which are responsible for the hardness of the water. Now you can see here, if in water calcium, magnesium 2 plus are present, that water will be hard. And we measure this hardness in parts per million unit. As the calcium and magnesium salts increases in water sample, hardness of the water is increases. And ppm, we measure it in ppm units. Ppm means parts per million. So as here you see, soft, we go soft to hard water. That is, as the salts is increases in ppm units, water gets more harder. This is the scale of the hardness of the water. If 0 to 60 ppm in salt, it's a soft. 60 to 120, it is moderately hard. And 120 to 180, it is hard water. And above 180, if above 180 ppm hardness is present in water, that is called very hard water. So why we are so much interested in the hardness of the water? Why we select this topic? So now we come effect of the water. You can just guess by this after this slide, what will be the effect of the hard water. You see here, it's affected the ecosystem of the sea. Underwater animal planets are badly affected by the hard water. You can search from other sources how much it is. From the slide, you can see it's not good for the human skin, especially for the delicate skin of the children. And in hard water, we have to use much more amount of soaps or detergent for formation of the lather. And we are not recommended hard water as drinking water. And most important effect is in our industry. In industry, where boiler is used, and in boiler water is used, hard water may cause the corrosion. You see here, hard water may corrosion here. If we use hard water in boiler, it may cause corrosion. Whereas in soft water, it's okay. So it's very costly, cost affected in industry if we use hard water. This is our work today. We are interested in estimated of the hardness of the water in our lab. So how it possible? We already mentioned hardness means calcium and magnesium sulfate or bicarbonate present in the water sample. So we are interested in the estimate of that salt, how much salt is present in the water, by a method called titration. It's a simple titration. And you see from here, titration means just we place a conical flask, and here we take our water sample in which maybe some calcium or magnesium salts are present, and then something we used in our burette by which we measured the how much calcium and magnesium salts are present in our water sample. This is a simple titration method. Now we are interested in the solution of the burette. We know about the solution of the conical flask. It's just our sample, water sample. And In our bullet, we used a compound called EDTA. You just focus here. EDTA means ethylene diamine tetraacetic acid. It's an organic compound. And we now closely look at this compound. What is EDTA? You see here, it's a simple organic compound. Ethylene, eth means two. Here, two carbon is present, one and two. Diamine, di means two. Again, two nitrogen, two amine group is present, so it is di. Tetra means four, tetraacetic acid. Here, four acetic acid moiety. You see here, COOH is acetic acid. Here, this is the acetic acid. This is acetic acid, and this is also acetic acid. So, four acetic acid units are present here. So, this is our EDTA, by which we measure how much calcium and magnesium salts are present in our hard water. So, obviously, it is possible because EDTA reacts with the bivalent metals like calcium and magnesium. So, look at the next slide. See here, it is an EDTA. And here, two nitrogen group is present. Nitrogen has lone pair. It can form coordination bond. One bond by this nitrogen, another by this nitrogen. And this, we said it is acid. So acid liberate H plus ion and it gives O minus, 4O minus. This 4O minus also may form four coordination bonds again with bivalent metals like calcium and magnesium. So we get this type of complex. This is M means calcium or magnesium or zinc, any bivalent metals. And you see here the six bonds, nitrogen, one, two from nitrogen, third from O minus, third from O minus, third from O minus, then from O minus. So four from O minus and two from nitrogen. So six bonds may form with metal ions. You see, six bond form means which type of geometry? Do you have any idea? Yeah, it's say octahedral geometry. Now, a special thing has happened here. Why we take EDTA? Because EDTA gives a very good compounds like this, stable compounds. Another reason, and the most important reason is that EDTA, you see here, gives 1:1 complex. Why 1:1? Because one EDTA takes one metal. So one EDTA is to one metal. It is a 1:1 complex. It helps us to calculate how much hardness is present in water. We just correlate EDTA with metal. One EDTA takes one metal. So it helps us in our calculation. That's why we take EDTA. Now we look at the real picture. If calcium ion is present in water, takes EDTA, forms six bonds, and this is formation of a complex. It's a, again, it's a 1:1 complex, as we mentioned here. So we take EDTA in our bullet, and in our conical flux, we take the water sample. The problem is that by EDTA, we are measuring the how much calcium and magnesium salt is present. But EDTA is a secondary standard solution. That means the concentration of the EDTA changes with time. So EDTA is important here because by this solution, we are measuring calcium and magnesium. So we have to first calculate the concentration of the EDTA very correctly. But it's a secondary standard solution. That's why we have to use another solution, which is a primary standard solution, by which we calculate the strength of the EDTA very accurately. So what's that solution? That solution is simple zinc acetate solution. Zinc acetate is very good primary standard solution. Do you have any idea about primary standard solution? Yes, primary standard solution means the solution which concentration remains constant for a prolonged period of time. So we can take zinc acetate solution, which by accurate weighing, we can make certain known strength of zinc acetate solution. And by this, we can calculate easily the strength of the EDTA. So this is our task first. We first accurately made zinc acetate solution. so that we can know the accurate strength of the zinc acetate. Then using this zinc acetate, we measure the concentration of the EDTA. And that EDTA we used for the measurement of the hardness. Now this is our next task, a simple titration. First we titrate EDTA with zinc acetate so that we can know what is the strength of the EDTA. Then after knowing the strength of the EDTA, we just take our sample in our conical flux and used EDTA, the known concentration of the EDTA, to measurement how much calcium and magnesium salt present in our water sample. But you know, there is something missing here. In all the titration, we know we have to use something. Do you have idea what's that, what's missing? Yeah, indicator. Indicator. We take an indicator which indicates our end point of the titration. For this titration, we are using indicator which is called EBT. EBT indicator, it gives us a two color. You can see just after a while, two color. One is pink color, another is blue color. And it gives a very sharp color change. We get a very good result with this titration. Now, the question is why two color? We can understand when we see the titration in real. This is two color. Why two color? This is the EBT. It's also like EDTA organic compound. And it, with the metal present, metal maybe magnesium or calcium, it also gives a complex like EDTA. And this is why this two color we get. Bare EBT, only EBT has a color blue. And when it is complex with calcium and magnesium, it gives us a color pink color. So we get a color change, blue to pink or pink to blue. But we have to remember something here. We have to use a buffer solution to get the result properly. Buffer means just a solution, very small amount, like 5 ml amount, so that our pH of the solution just constant. Constant, we are using ammonium chloride, ammonium hydroxide buffer, which has pH 10 to 10.5. So this is our scheme. First, we prepare a known concentration of zinc acetate solution by accurate owing. This is our first step. Second, then we are using this zinc acetate by titrate EDTA to know, to determine the strength of the EDTA, the exact strength of the EDTA, as EDTA strength is changed with time. So before the work, we have to know what is the exact strength of the EDTA. So first titration is zinc acetate versus EDTA to know the strength of the concentration of the EDTA. Third one, estimation of the hardness of the water. You take any sample of water in conical flux and take the EDTA which strength is known and just look at the titration. You follow the instruction as given. This is how we make our zinc acetate solution. 1000 ml 1 molar zinc acetate means molecular weight of zinc acetate. We make 250 ml m by 40 zinc acetate. So you can calculate how much we take zinc acetate by, say it is 5 gram. So you accurately weighing 5 gram of zinc acetate to make the primary standard solution. This is our simple calculation. We are using this equation, V1S1 equal to V2S2. Let's start our titration. This is zinc acetate, a powder, white powder like compound. You can see from here, the crystalline compound, bright white crystalline compound. This is zinc acetate, which molecular weight we have to know, it is 219.49, approximately 219.5. And it is EDTA, ethylene diamine tetraacetic acid. We're very much interested for this. It's a powder-like, again, powder-like white compound, you can see, CDTA. So secondary standard solution, it's a primary standard solution. So we have to first, by weighing, accurate weighing, we have to make zinc acetate solution. It's a M/40 zinc acetate solution. This solution, just we put this solution, zinc acetate by accurate way and distill water and make this solution. Now, in our conical flux, take this here for proper pipette out. It's a 25 ml pipette. Make sure up to the mark 25 ml, exactly 25 ml. It's a quantitative analysis, so you have to be careful about that. You have to take accurately 25 ml pipette out of zinc acetate solution in our conical flux. We know the strength of this zinc acetate accurately, it's M/40. Now we have to take the buffer solution, add buffer solution. It is ammonium chloride, ammonium hydroxide buffer, pH 10 to 10.5. We have to add 5 ml of buffer solution for proper color change of the EBT indicator. Careful, say ammonia, concentrated ammonia. I get smell. So we add in zinc acetate this 5 ml of buffer solution. Now we are expecting something here. We add EBT indicator. Indicator, we expect indicator do its work, its proper work. Just a pinch of indicator. Let's look how it is changed. So zinc acetate buffer. Buffer does not react anything with zinc acetate, so zinc is present here. We add EBT and it turns colorless to pink. So its complexation is forms. EBT complexed with the zinc and we get a pink color. Now here in burette we take EDTA. We say EDTA solution, we have to know the exact strength of this solution by zinc acetate. So we take this in 50 ml burette. Up to the mark, make it properly. Now I place here in burette stand and it's ready for our titration. Drop wise you pour the EDTA in the zinc acetate solution. We have to take the exact color change. We stop when color change pink to something else. when we pour EDTA, EDTA reacts with the zinc ion present in our conical flux. EBT, we add just a pinch of EBT. So EBT takes just a small amount of zinc and makes the color pink. Rest of the zinc is present in our conical flux. So EDTA now is reacting with that part of the zinc, all the zincs. When it reacts with all the zincs, then something has happened. Reacting with zinc. EDTA takes all the zincs from zinc acetate and makes form complex. Up to now, EBTA is with zinc. EBTA is with zinc as a complex. As we now we see the color change. This is blue color. And we take the reading from here. Blue color means EBT. From EBT, zinc is out. And now EBT is bare. EBT is free. So we get this blue color. And from the burette, we have the reading. It's 27.5. So we have to use this reading. Note down the reading, 27.5. We have to use this reading when we are calculation. So this is the standardization of EDTA by zinc acetate solution. We standardize, we get a reading that is 25 ml. We take 25 ml of zinc acetate solution here. So 25 ml of zinc acetate solution reacts with the 27.5 ml of EDTA solution. By this reading, we can calculate the strength of the EDTA exactly. Now, second step, we are now going to estimate the hardness of the water sample. For this, in a conical flux, this is our water sample, we take 100 ml of water. You can use water from any source to measure how much hardness is present in water sample. This is 100 ml, exactly 100 ml. We take this in our conical flask. So if any hardness, any calcium, magnesium salt is present, we can estimate by this method. Now, we add 5 ml of buffer solution again for getting the indicator's color properly. Just 5 ml of ammonium hydroxide, ammonium chloride buffer, which gives this solution exactly pH 10 to 10.5, which is optimum pH for the color change of the EBT indicator. Now we add a pinch of EBT indicator. This shows, is there any hardness is present, yes or not? This EBT indicator, we pour here. See, a very distinct pink color. So EBT, there is hardness is present in water sample, and EBT reacts with the calcium and magnesium ion and gives this color. Now, we take EDTA. In our burette, again, we load our burette by EDTA to estimate the hardness of the water. So just a simple titration, water sample, you need water sample, buffer, EBT indicator and EDTA. And easily you can estimate hardness of the water of any source. Now our burette is ready. Conical flux, water sample is present. We give EBT, gives us a distinct color, which shows there is hardness. Now we are going to how much hardness is present. Start our titration and stop when the color changes to blue. Changes. So color changes to blue, pink to blue. We take the burette reading. It's 5.4. We have to memorize it. It's 5.4 for our estimation of the hardness of the water. So this is the second titration. Now we are going for the calculation. For these two reading, we can very easily calculate how much hardness is present in our water sample. Now let's go for the calculation. Let's calculate how much hardness is present in our water sample. So this is the calculation, simple calculation. First we prepare the zinc acetate solution. Accurately, because it's a primary standard solution, by accurate weighing. So we know 1000 ml 1 molar. This is an easy relation. 1000 ml 1 molar means any compound means the molecular weight of that compound. So the molecular weight of the zinc acetate, the molecular weight of zinc acetate is 219.5, approximately 219.45 to 219.5. So for 1000 ml, if we make 1000 ml 1 molar zinc acetate solution, we have to add 219.5 gram zinc acetate and in 1000 ml water we have to add 219.5 gram zinc acetate, because this is the molecular weight of the zinc acetate solution. Now we made 250 ml. You see here 250 ml volumetric flux we are using. So 250 ml m by 40. So it's a very easy calculation. 219.5 divided by 1000 into 40 into 250. So this is the weight we have to accurate weight. We calculate 219.5 into 250 as we make 250 ml solution divided by 1000 divided by 40. Calculator gives us reading 1.372 gram. So you have to use a balance so that you can accurately weight 1.372 gram zinc acetate solution. Just use a digital balance, weight 1.372 gram zinc acetate, take in your volumetric flux and add 250 ml of water up to the mark and make your zinc acetate solution is ready. It's exactly m by 40 strength. It's a known strength. Now we are using this zinc acetate solution for our first titration, that is to know the strength of the EDTA. Now we have to find out what is the strength of the EDTA. We just recall the first titration. We take 25 ml of zinc acetate in conical flux. So volume of the zinc acetate is 25 ml we take in our conical flux. We know the strength of the zinc acetate is m by 40 because we made it by accurate weighing. So It is our V into S. You recall the small equation, V1 S1 equal to V2 S2. We are using that. V, volume of zinc acetate. We take 25 ml pipette or 25 ml of zinc acetate. Then into the strength of the zinc acetate, M by 40. We don't know the exact strength of the EDTA. So this EDTA strength is unknown. So S, we have to calculate S. Into, we know from the burette, the volume of the EDTA. That is, can you remember anybody? What is the first reading? 27.5. Yeah, it is 27.5. So for this equation, we can easily calculate what will be our S in molar, it is unit, in molality. So S will be 25 divided by 27.5 divided by the 40. It is 0.0227 molar. So easily we get the strength of the EDTA. The strength of the exact, now we know the exact strength of the EDTA. It's ready for our estimate the hardness of the water. Our EDTA strength is 0.0227 molar. Now the second step, you can remember the second step. We take water sample in our conical flux and titrate it with this EDTA. Do you remember the value of the title reading, second title reading? Anybody? No? The second title reading is 5.4. So we are now using this 1000 ml 1 molar EDTA. We have to understand just this thing, this line. 1000 ml 1 molar EDTA means 1000 ml 1 molar calcium carbonate. If calcium is present as calcium carbonate. Why? Because you recall it's a 1:1 complex. 1 EDTA takes 1 calcium. So its molality is same, 1:1. So we can calculate very easily. 1000 ml 1 molar EDTA means molecular weight of the EDTA. As 1 mole EDTA takes 1 mole calcium carbonate, so it's also molecular weight of the equivalent to molecular weight of the calcium carbonate. So we can correlate this. 1000 ml 1 molar EDTA means 1000 ml 1 molar calcium carbonate. I repeat this again. Why? Because it's a 1:1 complex. 1 EDTA takes 1 calcium ion. So when 1 molecular weight EDTA takes 1 molecular weight of calcium, 1 molecular weight of calcium carbonate. If it is present, we are measuring the hardness as if calcium carbonate, as a scale of calcium carbonate. So 1000 ml 1 molar EDTA equivalent to 1000 ml 1 molar calcium carbonate means the molecular weight of calcium carbonate. Because we know anything 1000 ml 1 molar any compound means their molecular weight. We know that molecular weight of calcium carbonate is 100 gram. We are calculating its ppm unit, so we convert gram to mg. 100 into 1000, right? We are converting gram to mg. Now you recall our second reading, when we estimate the hardness of the water, our EDTA reading is 5.4. So 5.4 ml and our strength of the EDTA is 0.2227 molar EDTA means how much calcium carbonate. If 1000 ml 1 molar, then 100 gram, 100 gram, that is 100 into 1000 mg calcium carbonate. If it is now, our reading is 5.4, so 5.4.0227 molar means 1000 into by 5.4 into 0.0227. Five point four into 0.0227. This 12.258 mg calcium carbonate. Do anybody remember that how much we take the water sample? The volume of the water sample? We take 100 ml of water sample. So in 100 ml. This amount of hardness is present. We have to calculate in 1 liter how much hardness is present. So in 100 ml, in our water sample in 100 ml, 12.258 mg calcium carbonate present as hardness. So in 1000 ml, how much? This is equal to 122.58 ppm. In 1 liter, we are calculating in mg terms. That means it ppm unit. Okay, so in our sample, hardness of water is 122.58 ppm. So by this method you can calculate the hardness of water very easily from any source of water. Now let's go to our lab and do this titration yourself. Let's go.